Hello, I'm Mike with this week's new and trending AI tools you cannot afford to miss. And the biggest launch this week is definitely multimodal live API with Gemini 2.0. It can do so many things, and I'll save the best thing until last. But as you can see on the screen here, you can talk with Gemini, you can show things to Gemini, and you can even share your screen so this can help you with gaming and things like coding. Let's start by talking to Gemini. Tell me what accent I'm speaking to you in, and also tell me the emotions I'm displaying.
Okay, I can help you with that. You seem to have a British accent, and your tone suggests you're feeling curious and perhaps a bit playful.
Next up in my less than perfect recording environment, let's show Gemini something. Ah, hello there. Can you tell me what I'm holding up to the camera, please? What is this?
Sure, it appears that you are holding a dragon fruit. The fruit is bright pink with green leafy extensions.
Okay, let's use the multimodal live API to share my screen and play a game. Okay, I've never played this game before. Tell me what game I have on my screen.
Sure, that's Minecraft Classic. It's an early version of the popular sandbox game, Minecraft.
Great. Okay, so based on what I'm looking at, what should be the first thing I should do to start interacting with this game?
Typically, in Minecraft, you start by gathering wood. You can do this by punching the tree trunks. This allows you to craft tools and other useful items.
Okay, what did I just do there?
You have successfully punched a block of wood off of the tree. Now you can use that to make planks. Would you like to know how to make planks?
I can also use it for coding. For instance, in Cursor, I might create something with a composer. Okay, finally, we'll share the screen. Can you see what I'm sharing with you?
It seems to be Swift code, and the project is called Tide Times.
Excellent. So this will show Tide Times, as you can see, on the phone on the right-hand side. Can you see that?
Yes, I see the app preview on the right side, displaying tide times for Phuket beaches with a graph and text.
Marvelous. Okay, so I've got this really cool app that works on iOS, but I also want to create a widget. And I know before I go back to my code editor, I need to set some stuff up in Xcode. Can you help me with that to create a widget for the lock screen, please?
Okay, to start creating a widget for your app, the first thing you'll need to do is add a new target to your Xcode project. This target will specifically be for the widget extension.
How do I add a new target?
To add a new target, go to the File menu in Xcode, then select New, and then choose Target. This will bring up a window with different target types.
Okay, I've done that. So where do I need to click now to make that widget?
Okay, now you should see a window with different target options. You'll want to choose the Widget Extension option under the iOS tab. Then click Next to continue with the setup.
Perfect, that's done. So what do I type here?
In the next screen, you'll need to enter a name for your widget extension in the product name field. You can also customize other options, but for now, you can leave those as default and click Finish.
So as you can see, Google Gemini 2.0 with the multimodal live API has helped me to create a widget extension inside Xcode. And now you can see it's created the Tide Times widget folder here, meaning I can go back over to Cursor and get that widget created. As you can see, it's made some comprehensive changes, which I've accepted. And now you can see in a snap, it's created a widget here for my home screen, which is really fantastic. And I wouldn't have been able to do this unless I set this widget up inside Xcode first. And of course, Google's Gemini 2.0 guided me to do that. Final cool use case, I was in Hanoi in Vietnam this week, and I actually uploaded some audio of a street announcement in Vietnamese as I really wanted to know what was being said. Let's have a quick listen to what that audio sounds like. So as you can hear, the audio quality is low, but it translated perfectly what was being said, and I asked it to summarize what was said, and it said it was informing Hanoi citizens about the city's effort to improve sidewalk order, traffic safety, and administrative efficiency. How fantastic is that? So there you go. The future is most definitely AI agents. I'm looking forward to 2025, where we're going to be interacting with AI just like real humans to get jobs done. And that's it for this very short update this week. I definitely wanted to let you know about Gemini 2.0, which is a fantastic new launch from Google. And if you're in the premium section of my community, I'm doing an AI advent calendar every day for the month of December with a brand new AI idea inside 5 minutes every day. Here's what I covered on day 11. I thought it would be quite interesting for you, where I can pair different LLMs for different jobs. If you're wondering where you should be using Gemini, Claude, or OpenAI's ChatGPT, watch this. So sharing my screen here today, and this is a workflow I've done for AI Mike. You might have seen in the YouTube channel, I actually shared the workflow of how I'm calling my RAG database with OpenAI embeddings. I'm merging together the, I think it's four pieces of context from my YouTube video transcripts, and then combining them together, talking to AI Mike, essentially prompting him. And again, I shared this in my recent YouTube video, how I'm prompting AI Mike. And then AI Mike is responding to the community using a make automation because Circle doesn't integrate with NA10 right now. So I've chosen to use Claude Sonnet 3.5 to do the responses. I found it to be the safest and the most practical. GPT 4.0 Mini was also good, but I was also playing with Gemini Flash 1.5. And today I wanted to do a huge shout out to Stephen, who's a premium member. And he actually shared a video with me fairly recently. And I'll just play you the first few seconds of it.
We favor Gemini 1.5 Flash over everything else.
And that's literally the key piece of information. Now, I definitely suggest you watch the whole video, but essentially he said, we favor Gemini 1.5 Flash over everything else. So today I wanted to go into what LLM or what AI model should you use for what? And let's actually go ahead and let's get rid of all of this and start kind of with basically just the AI models here. And we'll call this this workflow, which LLM, okay? And I wanted to give you some demos. So first of all, I'll go in and I'll insert a trigger and we'll do on chat message like so, okay? So this means when a chat message is received, go and talk to an AI model, and we'll link this up to advanced AI and we'll go for the basic LLM chain and we'll take it from the previous node, which will be the chat node. And then we can choose which model we're going to hook up and talk to, okay? So we can test different things. So obviously I can hook this up to OpenAI. I can click chat, see it opens up in line here. And let's just move this about so we can actually see things. So let's scroll down here. Okay, so we're talking to OpenAI 4.0 Mini, sorry. Hello. And there you go. You can see the workflow working. How can I assist you today? Okay. And then again, I can delete this link and I can put it into Anthropic. You good? Yes, I'm doing well. Okay. And then we can go to Gemini 1.5 Flash. And I do think this is the hidden gem here. Now, what I wanted to try and do is actually get a YouTube video. Do you know what? Let's use this YouTube video that I've mentioned. So this is a 50-minute podcast. And I want to explain to you as concisely as I can in the remaining 2 minutes how I would use all these models. So ChatGPT, in my experience, has been good for technical finding out of how to do things. How do I do this? How do I make that work? Help me with this. Help me understand this concept. That's ChatGPT for me, in a nutshell. Anthropic is the best writer ever, which is why I've used Anthropic for AI Mike, because it just writes like a human. And I think we all understand that. Many people say Anthropic Claude is a great writer. So we understand how those two models work, but I don't think people are paying enough attention to Gemini. Particularly Gemini Flash, which is super, super cheap, like way cheaper than ChatGPT and Claude. And it's got that million token context window, so you can put a lot of data into it. So for instance, I'm going to go to this episode here, this podcast episode on YouTube. I'm going to pop open the description and we'll scroll down. Now you see it's got nice chapters already. Show transcript, and here it is. Now I'm going to, for the moment, actually no, we'll leave the timestamps on, and I'll show you why I'm going to do that. Now I'm going to go through and scroll all the way to the bottom and copy all of that transcript, okay? And now we're going to go back and we're going to see how good each model fares at summarizing the transcript. We'll save Flash until last, and spoiler alert, I think you'll be impressed. So let's start with GPT 4.0 Mini, and we'll say, and again, this is probably not the best window to do it because it's very small, but we'll say, summarize this, and then we'll post in the whole thing. Ooh, and I'm going to do another test to see if it hallucinates or not. Summarize this and summarize, let's be specific, in a paragraph and give chapters. Now, I just wanted to say there's no memory here to this chat window. So when I hook to the other AI models, it's not going to see any of my previous posts. So it won't impact this experiment. Okay, I'm copying that so I can do it for Anthropic and Gemini. And we'll just send that to ChatGPT 4.0 Mini and we'll see what comes back. So that's the whole YouTube transcript with timestamps. And we'll wait for 4.0 Mini to get back to us. Let's actually move this over so we can see the response when it comes in. Might take a while. Okay. This is a nice summary, a nice little paragraph there. And it's given us quite a nice little timestamp. I don't know how accurate those timestamps are, but now let's unhook this from Gemini, put it into Claude Sonnet. That's an expensive model. And we'll give the same prompt with the same transcript, and we'll see how Claude Sonnet 3.5. Didn't mind how GPT 4.0 mini came in, but I didn't like the way that it... It essentially gave 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. Now, down here, now Claude has actually ignored giving me timestamp chapters. It's just given me chapters as numbered points, which is okay. And this is quite a full-on and comprehensive summary. And now let's try that same prompt again with Gemini Flash 1.5, the cheapest of them all. And we'll paste in the same content again. And let's see how fast Gemini Flash is to come back, and what it comes up with is looking over the whole transcript. And this is pretty good. So again, it's got really good information here, and it's got what seem to be quite detailed timestamps. Now, I realize I didn't actually say, you know, do it like a YouTube timestamp. So maybe I should have been more specific there. So summarize this in a paragraph and give chapters in YouTube style like this. 0.00 intro and so on. Okay, and we'll wait and see what Flash comes back with, and hopefully it'll give like a nice paragraph and chapters. Okay, didn't put them on new lines, but that's probably because of the window I'm working in. But it's a nice paragraph here and a nice set of chapters all the way towards the end of the video. So again, we can see that each model handled it fairly well. But what I can tell you from my experience, because I've been using a lot of AI to write descriptions and chapters for my YouTube videos, I was using Claude 3.5 Sonnet for a long time, until it started hallucinating and missing out parts of my video. And I was like, it's not grabbing the whole context from my video. It's missed out whole chunks. And then I moved to Gemini Flash 1.5. And so far, I'm having an incredible amount of success. So what I'm trying to say to you in today's Advent Calendar Door is, if you have a whole lot of information or large transcripts or audio that you've converted from speech into text, you probably want to try throwing it into Gemini Flash 1.5. In my experience so far, it's been the best at accurately summarizing long-form content. There you go. That is content exclusively for premium members. If you want to get something like this every single day during the month of December, join the premium section of the Creator Magic community. The link is down below. Thanks so much for watching. I've been using my AI-generated avatar to bring you the content this week, as I'm in less than perfect recording conditions. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you want to try HeyGen out yourself that I'm using to make this avatar, that link is down below too.